Hey everybody, it's Evicta, Static Eating Streak here at the Binding of Isaac Evicta Afterbirth Plus series. We're sitting at 47 wins in a row. The streak still goes on. Thank you everybody for the support so far. Oh boy. We've got Chaos, we've got Alpha Sierra 37388 Papa. Not great damage, not great movement speed, decent tears rate, and not anything else that's particularly all that awesome. We also have a Temperance card here. And Curse of the Lost. So yeah, it's been a little while since I've actually played Isaac. It's been about a day or two. Like I said, I appreciate all the support and the patience here during a little bit of the Isaac downtime. Isaac is sort of on the back burner right now as far as series are concerned, because we have Darkest Dungeon, which of course is ramping down here as we get ready for, I don't know how we didn't take a hit there, which is ready going, it's, we're preparing for the final push in Darkest Dungeon, of course, in preparation for Season 3. When the Crimson Court DLC comes out. And of course, Dead Cells is doing pretty darn well as other projects. So Isaac is sort of on the, is in the last in the priority list, but that doesn't mean that I'm going to stop playing Isaac. Of course, I did talk about this earlier, a while ago actually, about how Isaac is going to be ramping down a little bit. Been seeing a little bit of a decrease in the production here, but it's still a game that I am enjoying, and I've got the streak. There's no reason to stop playing, especially when we have the streak. Now, whenever the streak ends, we'll probably talk about it. I don't know. I'm going to be pretty... It's going to be hard. You'll have a tough time convincing me to start up a brand new streak immediately after this Eden streak is over, whatever that may be. Just because, like, yeah, that's pretty much all I've done in the last year, almost, is just been Eden streaking and Afterbirth Plus, which is fine, because that's what I enjoy doing in Isaac. I mean, there's no, in my opinion, there's no other greatest accomplishment than a decently sized Eden streak, if you know what I mean. I don't know why we had to get semi-dirty there, but yeah, I'll probably, whenever the streak's over, I'll probably just take a break from Isaac, I guess. I mean, I'm not burned out. Like, I feel like Isaac is not really a game that you get burned out on. I will say that I have felt the... We should go in the cursed room. I have felt the sting a little bit after, you know, if I play particularly bad or something like that. I'll take fast bombs, I suppose. At least it gives us 5 more bombs. And we can go look for the secret room. We can also med back the HP that we just lost because we have that right there. And yeah, this is what I was looking for. I was hoping we get a Tinted Rock. So fast bombs are going to allow us to have a quicker placement of bombs, but they don't do anything else other than that. There's less of an internal cooldown on when we press the E button and when the bomb comes out. So I'm going to do the cardinal sin here, and well, first off, is anyone seeing this dodging going on right now? And secondly, I am going to take the soul heart. That's a cardinal sin in my book anyway, because usually you don't ever want to take a soul heart unless you can guarantee its safety into the next floor. Of course, I can't actually do that right now, but I'm just being a little bit lazy because I don't feel like going back. Oh man, we get the wafer for 15 cents in the first shop, and that's pretty darn good. We only need 5 cents. I'm debating of just simply throwing down the Temperance card here and being done with it all. I think that we should do that. Of course, I am going to be very cautious about our HP though, because we only have one. Basically, only have one HP after this. So we'll get down. I think that's good. I don't think I need to go any further than that. And we'll go grab the wafer. So the wafer is going to have all damage that we get. I will also buy this playing card here. Or we'll get the coupon. Okay. Alright, so the coupon is going to allow us to get one item for free in the store and or the Deal with the Devil. And the coupon is one of the best items to have come out in the game since Afterbirth Plus was released. In my opinion, it is completely broken and very good. So unfortunately, we did not get the... I didn't actually need to do that because we got this heart for free. This is taking up a little bit more time than I would like, but I am doing this just to make sure that we get that extra card that I want. There we go. So I feel confident enough to go down to a half heart. Not gonna worry about bombing that. Maybe this is a Joker card to a diamond. It's gonna double our money. Alright. Gonna be Monstro. Not really worried about Monstro. So anyway, yeah, the wafer is going to have all the damage that we get, no matter the source champion. Gonna be honest, I didn't think that we'd get hit there. I took that a little bit too, I guess, too. I didn't take enough sharp enough turn out of that shot. Book of Mysteries, Secrets, whatever you want to call it. It's pretty much worthless here. Head on down to the next floor. But hey, we got the coupon and the wafer. Not a huge fan of Chaos. How come I don't like Chaos? Well, Chaos tends to dilute the loot table for a deal with the devil. That being said, though, of course, you can have awesome stuff like, say, the wafer showing up in the shop for 15 cents. I mean, that's pretty darn cool. I'll take it. But generally speaking, I don't like the wafer solely because it does tend to ruin your deal with the devil chances of getting like an actual deal with the devil item, as opposed to like, you know, something that's terrible, like say you pay 1 HP and you get 1 HP upgrade, which is just a waste of movement to that point. Not a fan of Chaos. It does give you some extra consumables at the start though when you get it, so I guess there's a plus. There's some people who live and die by Chaos. I'm not one of those people. I think everyone knows my playstyle on Isaac by now is a little bit more conservative than most. And that's not necessarily a bad thing. I don't think there's anything wrong with being safe. Especially in a game that can get sort of out of control like Isaac can in a hurry if you let it. Speaking of out of control, this room's gonna take quite a long time for us to kill. Yeah, if we can somehow swing like an awesome damage upgrade from our boss or shop or item room, that'd be great. And if you don't know, by the way, what Chaos does, Chaos will shuffle the loot tables. So what that means is that basically all the loot tables will now contain every other item in the loot table that, for example, you'll find Deal with the Angel items inside of a shop. You can find Deal with the Devil items inside of just a regular item room, etc., etc. Which makes for very interesting runs, but again, the byproduct of that is the fact that Chaos does dilute Deal with the Devil items, which means that you're not going to always get those items that you're expecting, like a premier offensive item. So there's some drawbacks to it. Chaos can throw runs, but it can also save runs. It just sort of comes down to your tolerance for buffoonery and that sort of zaniness. Dingle, though. Yeah, still looking for our item room. I will go into the store. It's pretty much a foregone conclusion that I need to check every single store. Ooh, Vibrant Bulb. Because we do have the coupon. So I'm gonna use a bomb here, and this is just to give me enough money so I can double it. And let's see, we'll use the coupon for now that got us the bomb, and then I will buy this. I'll buy the battery. Hopefully, let's see. Trying to think of a way I can do this to save us enough to give us the best chance of getting the HP upgrade for free. Should have probably expected that. Alright. Well, if our luck in Darkest Dungeon lately has told me anything, it's to not expect good things when it comes to RNG. So in typical Sinvicta fashion, we have done a full clear of a floor that I was just simply trying to find the item room to. But hey, when we get a full charge, we'll be able to have a free HP upgrade if I feel like walking back and getting it, which right now I don't. Also a little bit mystified as to how the secret room was not above right here. There must be a gap on this side of the room. Oh. I would have bet everything that it would have been to the right of this room, but now seeing this room now tells me that it's probably north of this room, adjacent to the shop. Oh, I have no idea. I guess south of this room, maybe? Now I'm just doing it out of curiosity. Yeah, there it is. There we go. Just wanted to wait enough there so we can get that. There's another tinted rock here, which I will happily take. Everyone's been enjoying Dead Cells. I've been enjoying Dead Cells a whole lot. You can definitely draw some comparisons to Isaac because, well, there's just a lot of similarities with the item synergies, and you've got the roguelite genre. All those sort of familiar tropes and stuff. Not a huge fan of Bobby Bombs, but I will take extra bombs here. We could take Juice's Tongue. I'm not really feeling it, though. Pro 4, don't really care about that. Let's see what we get from our deal with the devil first. Before we do anything else, I would just want to see if we can get it, if we need to lock in our deal with the devil precedent, or if we can expect to have an angel room run this time around. Bobby Bomb's doing a little bit of favor for me. Why do I not like Bobby Bombs? Well, they tend to cause more problems than they solve. Sometimes they're great. Like in this fight, for example, against Little Horn, Bobby Bombs can be pretty darn good. Bobby Bombs are homing bombs, by the way. But there's also times where, if you're being pursued by a bunch of enemies like you were in the previous room with the Shamblers, Bobby Bombs be completely worthless, because it's just going to follow the enemies right towards you and lead them back right in your face, and that's not where you want them. Little Horn dunked himself. We got another useless item from the boss. And, yeah, looks like we are going to be going for a full-on angel room. I suppose I can just go to the curse room. There's no reason not to. I'm being super lazy here, but... yeah, that was probably worth it. Basically paid a bond for 2 soul hearts. Alright, head on down to the next floor. So, why do I not take a deal with the devil item? Well, because I don't really need Rainbow Baby, and the blue hourglass is not worth taking. Simple as that. Now, the nice thing about the Vibrant Bulb and Coupon combo is that there's really only one, technically two rooms that I would ever need to have the coupon for. In other words, we should always have a full charge on the coupon, unless if I've, like, you know, found a store recently or a devil deal. But given the fact that we don't have Deal with the Devil precedence, because I just straight up said no thanks to the game, it's going to be a while before we're going to actually use the coupon for anything. We're surprised that we got hit by those spikes there. I got through the corner, no problem, but yeah, anyway. Vibrant Bulb is going to give us a stat up every time we have a full charge on our spacebar item, which is pretty darn good. I've said pretty darn like 10 times now in today's run. Yeah, so that right there is the reason why Sinvicta does not like Bobby Bombs. It's because of that little homing that you just saw. When all I was doing was trying to open up the secret room along with, you know, killing an enemy, 2 birds with 1 stone, but that just wasted our last bomb, unfortunately. Alright, so hopefully we get some stats up soon. Well, you know, you could have just taken those pills. Yeah, but I think I've already established that. Sinvicta does not take pills. No longer does he take pills. He will start secondarily talking about himself in the third person, first person. What a variety. Gonna get a bomb here. Super secret room is sometimes to the right of that room that we were just at. I'm not convinced it's the secret room now. Now that I see that there's a gap over here, yeah, definitely not the secret room. I'm glad that I didn't waste our only bomb there. So we get Guppy's Tail and Mr. Dolly. And we get Steam Sale, okay. So I think it's worth it for us to try to get one of those items for free. We didn't. Got Mr. Dolly. And that's gonna give us a big tears up. And then we can come back here after we get a full charge and grab Guppy's Tail. A Guppy's Tail is not exactly a good idea here because we do have a little bit of a key deficit in order. To be honest, I thought that champion was going to go right past the mushroom. I think Guppy's Tail is only 3 cents. I really don't feel like walking all the way back here. We can just go get it. If I can grab that, I might as well grab this card as well. Strength card. So anyway, yeah, I don't know what I'm going to do after the streak is over, if and when that happens. I mean, this nothing lasts forever, and certainly Eden streaks do not last forever. I don't think that anyone, I don't know what the highest Eden streak is. Supposedly some streamer had an 800 Eden streak. Just, I mean, that's impressive. That's 700 more than I've ever gotten. I think the last streak, the streak that I've had was 121 wins or something like that in a row before I finally lost. Something spectacular like that. And I feel like that's an accomplishment. But 800 is just inconceivable to me. That's just a number that just seems unreachable. Like, I think that if I played that much Isaac in a row and just did nothing but Eden Streak, I definitely would feel the burn and just not want to play the game anymore. Like, I would have to take, like, a week or two off of Isaac before wanting to go back and play it more. And then what happens if you lose the streak, too? After you lose an 800 streak, it's like, okay, well, I guess we're just going to start... We're just going to start over from scratch. Guardian Angel, which... item that exists in the Binding of Isaac Afterbirth Plus. You know, Guardian Angel's not bad. It also existed in Vanilla Isaac as well. It's basically going to make your, to make your orbitals rotate slightly faster, but also counts as an orbital, which is pretty darn good. That's the eighth time I said that now in this video. You see the stat upgrade that we got because Vibrant Bulb gained a full charge thanks to us. Thanks to the way that the mechanic works, the mechanics work in the boss trap and mob trap rooms now. Every time you clear a wave, you get a charge, which is pretty neat. Like it. I mean, as it is going to be Champion Gertie, I'm going to purposely take damage here. It might seem stupid, but remember, we've got Swarm Protector. That's going to help speed things up a bit. And we have the Wafer, so I don't have to. I don't mind paying a half heart to do this, to speed this fight up. Because Black Gertie, of course, is the easiest of the Gerties, because she does not actually fire at you. She just spawns flies. So we did not get a deal with the Devil or a deal with the Angel, so we're just going to, again, take a non-stat upgrade and head on down. The only stat upgrade that we've gotten in this run, in this entire run, has been Mr. Freakin' Dolly. I shouldn't be doing this, but I'm going to. Yeah, that's exactly the reason why I shouldn't have done that. Alright. I think from now on, I'm just going to listen to my gut and just say no. If you think something's a bad idea, it probably is, and you shouldn't do it. And if you don't know what I'm talking about there, we have Guppy's Tail, which means that we're going to be generating less keys overall. And given the fact that we have zero keys, of course, that means that, well, basically, if we may screw ourselves out of item rooms. So, with only having two keys, going into a vault that requires two keys to enter doesn't really seem like all that sort of an optimal strategy, which, of course, it isn't. But then again, I'm not an optimal player, so never will I ever claim to be an optimal player. Or an optical player, either. Definitely not an optical player. You don't want to look into my eyes. You're not going to see anything but hatred and bacon and possibly bad life choices, I don't know. Projecting a little bit here. Alright, so just looking for a key. Just could use a key. How Canadian Are You has been doing great. And I want to let the world know right now, it took a long time for me to get Northern Line to do that. I first told him about resurrecting the How Blank Are You series. Because it started off with How British Are You. I told him about doing a Canadian one back in November of 2016. And we finally did it in June of 2017. So let this be a lesson to any of you aspiring YouTubers out there. If you want to try to collab with somebody who's a much bigger and better YouTuber than you are, be prepared to wait a whole lot, even if they are a friend of yours. Now, I'm not saying that NL, of course, purposely flaked on me. It's just that he's a busy guy. It's not like that we had this all planned out. We didn't have, like, let's schedule How Canadian Are You for June 2017. How's that time slot work? Well, I don't know, because I've got E3, and I've got to do the roundtable thing. That's not what he sounds like, but by the way, yes, you can totally say you told yourself so with the whole key situation right now. Because it doesn't look like we're going to get a key for the rest of this floor. And possibly the rest of this run, which honestly, I don't know if that's an upgrade or not, but you know, we haven't gotten any stat ups in forever. So we'll go into the item room now, and it's going to be scatter bombs. Can we get like a non-bomb upgrade? I just want one non-bomb upgrade that's a stat upgrade. I don't even care if it's a speed stat. Just give me something, game. Because the only stat up that we got right now is the Vibrant Bulb, and that's not going to last us too much longer. I told Ryan back in November, I was like, hey, I've got this really cool show called How British Are You? And I'd love to start doing other countries. Would you be interested in doing a How Canadian Are You? He was like, oh yeah, that sounds like fun. Sure, what do I need to do? I told him, he's like, cool, no problem. Let's try to do it in December when his schedule frees up. Then it happened in June. It's good Canadian timing there. I know everyone misses the GeoGuessr series. I miss the GeoGuessr series too. I miss playing GeoGuessr with my friends. But I can't force someone to play something. And people, for whatever reason, think that I had something. I didn't even see that creep there. That I had something to do with the GeoGuessr series not coming back, or that Ryan and I had a falling out, or I don't know, whatever. Fake drama people want to make up these days about people on YouTube. It's not true at all. we just stopped recording it. And the last time, after it was about a week after we recorded the last session of GeoGuessr, where I was like, all right, so I'm good on Monday or Tuesday. He's like, yeah, I really can't do it this week. And then that week turned into another week, and then it's like, okay, well, I think I'm just going to stop asking for now. I mean, to be quite honest, GeoGuessr just did not do very well at all on my channel because everyone watched his point of view, which is to be expected. But I was never doing the... I wasn't doing the series in the, to begin with for views. I was doing it just because I like, you know, me and Ryan, we enjoy playing similar games, and I think that we have pretty good chemistry with each other. Or not. Blue Baby's only friend might actually be doing more damage than we are right now. Still looking for those keys, though. We got plenty of bombs, but, woo. Hey, Chubb. Hello, Chubb. Alright, so we're still not guaranteed to spawn a special door on this room, or on this floor either, by the way. I mean, get ready for what could be a very long run, all thanks to Chaos. This would be the picture-perfect-esque of why I don't like Chaos. And why I don't like Guppy's Tail, and why I shouldn't have picked up Guppy's Tail in the first place. I got tricked, it was a bait and switch. I saw Pie in the Sky of Dreams there with a half-price Guppy's Tail for 3 cents. And I was tempted. So we are going to get growth hormones, which is great. And then we get Boom and Ghost Baby inside of the angel deal. So I'm going to take the bombs, and we're just going to head on down to the next floor, because we've got no keys. All right. I mean, even if, like, Ryan and I don't ever do another video together, period, for the rest of time, I'm still happy that I had the chance to record some stuff with him. Because, I mean, the culling, like, a lot of people were really bummed out about the culling. And, I mean, I won't lie, I too was also bummed that we stopped doing it, but that was a case of not us, that wasn't a case of our schedules being terrible. That was a case of the game being, like, completely broken. By the time, like, every time we fired up the culling to do a new recording session, we had to learn the game over again. And I spent a long time having to catch up on patch notes, because obviously Ryan does not have time to read them. And I read them, and I was like, yeah, dude, it's like a whole different game now. And that, we had that same conversation at least 3 times over the course of the culling's run. Diamonds, just gonna use that now. It was, which, ooh! Alright. Hoping we get a key out of here. We did. So this key, I think, is best used inside of the store. Whenever, if ever, we find one. But the combat system has completely changed conversation. I'm not kidding you, 3 times over the course of the culling series. And already compounding to an already big issue with us, which was that we could not guarantee usable games every time we tried to record. That was really the biggest thing that killed the culling for us, was the fact that we just could not. We would waste 2 to 3 hours trying to get a game that was usable. Because most of the games that we scrapped were like, I mean, the banter was like okay, but it wasn't anything special. And it certainly didn't save, like, a terrible game. Like, where one of us would die within the first, like, you know, 5-10 minutes or so. And then it's like, okay, well, we can't exactly start over. I should actually open up that Thorn's chest. We can't exactly start over because, like... Or we can't exactly keep going because it's already been 10 minutes. That's going to be a really long video. And people just don't watch long videos on YouTube. And at the same time, it's like, well, we also can't stop right now because we have to get a recording. I mean, we have to get something for our time. So us having to relearn the game on top of the fact that the combat system kept changing all the time, and you know, other than us generally just being not that great at the game, made things very difficult to record for. So we're gonna get Eucharist, which is gonna guarantee angel deals. It's basically the angel version of Goathead. Now I would be super stoked about this, except the fact that we have Chaos. We can get Beelzebub here, though, with this fly, with the friend zone. So at least we get flying out of that, and we get a decent orbital with that. If you're wondering where we got the Beelzebub transformation from, it's basically because we have Blue Baby's only friend that counts as one, then we have Swarm Protector as the other one, and then the Friend Zone is the third one. So did they? Was there or was there not a key in here? And no, I didn't care about using the coupon because we have plenty of money. No reason for me to. But we're guaranteed to get angel deals from here on out. Eucharist is a very rare item that you barely... I don't think anyone's ever seen me use before. I'm just going to sit here and let Blue Baby's only friend do most of the work. There we go. So we get Bomb Bag. I don't know what's up with all these bomb items here. And I suppose we'll take Demon Baby because a Soul Converter just doesn't matter for us. Would love to get into our item room. Really love it. I'm gonna hit this troll chest here. Got the counterfeit penny, which is pretty bad comparatively speaking to Vibrant Bulb. I mean, if I have to, I will go play that slot machine. I really don't want to though. Give me a key. One key. And I mean, again, I appreciate these bombs, game. I really do. But unless you give me a bombs or kill. Yeah, bombs or kill pills. Keys. I don't really have much use for them. And this is, again, the product of us taking Guppy's tail. Got hounded by the hollow there. We might as well go just do a full clear. Was that a temperance machine or was that an actual slot machine? No, it was the mirror. Never mind. Last assist. What are you doing here? You're on the wrong floor here, buddy. Alright, well. Unfortunately, we're going to skip another item room. I could go play the sacrifice room, but I think that would be just a waste of time and energy and money. Ping it once, might as well. Alright. Maybe the super secret room will help us. Alright, head on down the next floor. I don't know what to call this run, man. It's not bad, but it's not good. I think that us getting all these bomb upgrades... It's honestly, to be 100% like clear... I'm blaming mostly all of this on Chaos. But at the same time, I have no idea why we keep getting more and more bomb items. I really don't. I wish there was a Bomber Boy transformation or something. Or like a Wrath transformation. I think that would be cool. Turn into Wrath and you gain explosion immunity. And you have like a... Thanks, Bomb Bag. You have like a... 25% chance to shoot a Dr. Fetus tier every time you shoot. I think that'd be neat. Maybe a 5% chance to shoot a an Epic Fetus tier. I don't know. I think it's a good idea. If Nicholas hired me and only paid me $5 an hour to come up with ideas for Isaac, I would totally take that. It would not even be a question. I would happily do it. Be involved with a game like that. A game that I'm a huge fan of would be really cool. Oh god, I don't know what happened to monsters there. They like hit each other in the air. Go back and watch that the last couple of seconds of this room and look how they collided in the air with each other. That was a little bit frightening. Yo. Got plenty of bombs, so I might as well look for a justice card or something, or a Wheel of Fortune card. I mean, tower card's not exactly what I wanted. Oh boy. Alright, if we can just get the flat penny, anything that generates keys, I'll feel a lot better about our situation. Again, I'd like to point out the only stat up that we've technically gotten in this run has been... I take that back. We've also... We've also gotten growth hormones as well. Growth hormones are great, don't get me wrong. They're a great upgrade. They lead towards the spun transformation. They give you movement speed and a decent damage up as well. Pretty much have to open every single chest that we see. Sticky nickel, I don't really care about. But man, if we could just get a key. Pretty sure, I thought that Blue Baby's only friend was going to be able to kill that knight. There's a, I mean, there's a lot of disappointment that has to be tempered with explanations, because a lot of people seem to get the wrong impression when it comes to collabs on YouTube. If, like, if one of your favorite collab series ever, like, crashes and burns, sometimes I think people jump to the conclusions way too fast. Either that, or I think that some people in this country, or in the world, actually, sort of suffer from a, they want to find drama where drama doesn't exist just for the entertainment of it all. It's like watching a car wreck. You know, it's like, it's terrible, it's absolutely horrific of what's going on, but you can't stop looking at it. If that's too macabre for you, then, I think you'll be alright. You know what I mean. It's not like I'm the one causing the car wreck, I'm sitting there just watching it, you know? I don't know. A lot of people, just try to empathize with the YouTubers. If they, even if they did have a falling out, you know, just understand that YouTubers are like any other person out there. Some are a little bit weirder than most, I will say that. But sometimes projects just, they flop. For whatever reason, sometimes they're not worth it, sometimes they are. Maybe, you know, they just don't feel like doing it anymore. You just really don't know. There's a lot of stuff that happens in behind closed doors of YouTube that I feel people would probably be surprised to hear. But then you're gonna, like, that sort of paints me as, like, a whistleblower or a conspiracy theorist, which I'm not. I pride myself in being as loyal as possible to my craft and my friends. Especially my friends. I try to make everything work for the best for the channel. If I could control collabs, you know, I would lobby for more, for a little bit more variety as far as collabs are concerned, as well as the, I mean, even like the Team LE stuff, like, it's sometimes a chore to get everyone in together. It's not because we don't like playing with each other, we don't like playing the game, it's just, it really comes down to, you're talking to three very busy people. So we successfully got through this entire floor without seeing a single key. I was really hoping that that the arcade was going to bail us out, but turns out, not going to happen. We can't get into the store, so I don't know if I'd be able to buy a key in there. Yeah, I mean, this run, the biggest mistake was taking Guppy's tail. I should not have been tempted by that. Because that compounds the problem with us having chaos as well, because we're getting even less items because we don't have the keys for it. So, another angel deal, another useless item. Yep. Gonna keep on rocking and rolling here. And then there's collabs that just sort of accidentally happen. Like the PUBG. The PUBG videos with Force and Crendoge and whoever else happens to be with us at the time are great. I think it's great content. People seem to really enjoy it, but it's certainly not content that I can guarantee delivery on, you know, because once you start attaching schedules and stuff to those sort of things, it sort of changes the dynamics of the video, as well as the game in general. You know, and the commentary, too, because you go from just friends wanting to play video games with each other to, okay, you know, hey, you're late. You know, I thought that we agreed on this time, or, you know, I don't really have enough time to do this or this or that. It just puts unneeded pressure on the situation, which should be a very stress-free, easy, you know, easily doable process. And I'm happy that that the PlayerUnknown's Battlegrounds stuff has been doing decently on YouTube. Oh my god, we found a key. Stop the press now. Hold on. Pause the commentary. We found a key. It took us a floor and a half to get it, but by God, we did it. It's a miracle of modern science. Really don't like this. Thank God we've got the wafer. I think you lost Swarm Protector. There we go. Really? I'm surprised and shocked that Secret Room is not above this room. Game-breaking bug? I mean, we might as well just go for broke anyway. Now, if you're wondering why I'm still using Blue Baby's Only Friend, it's mainly because the damage may be slightly worse than our tier's damage, but I can increase the uptime substantially as opposed to our tier damage. And generally speaking, I can usually stay pretty safe as well. Second time we've been hit by Monstro in this run. I mean, is it too early to start hoarding keys right now? I don't think so. Especially if we're going to the chest, like, we're going to need keys. I really hate that Guppy's Tail has not been paying out for us as far as regular chests that we can open after every room clear. As far as that goes. Yeah, that's all I want. I mean, you don't have to do much to please me, game. All I want is just a random chest with a key in it every now and then. That's completely fine. If I could have it my way, we would still have GeoGuessr. We would be doing. I mean, Ryan and I briefly talked about me competing in a race video in a race series with him. Very similar to how he and Mathis used to do it. But you know, and that never really produced anything either. For me, it's not about doing the collabs with Ryan as much as just playing games with him, because both of us do tend to enjoy the same type of games, which is awesome. It's how me and Husky also are as well. You know, the StarCraft collab on the co-op video that we did, you know, that was surprisingly well. Like, a lot of people were shocked to see StarCraft back on the channel, and to be 100% honest, I wasn't even planning on bringing StarCraft back to the channel. It was Husky who was like, hey, you should record these just because. And far be it for me to tell Husky what I think is, you know, I'm not going to act like I know more about YouTube than Husky. You know, I just do it. Oh, we got an Emperor card, thank goodness. Emperor card's going to save a lot of time on this run. I'll open one of these. All right, we got a key. As long as we get a key back, I'll keep opening golden chests. There you go on that. Alright, so the Emperor card is going to give us a quick out of the chest. But, you know, whenever Husky says, like, hey, you should probably record this, I generally listen to him because he's going to know what's good content, what's not. You know, I personally didn't think that the Canadian video would do all that well. And the reason why that is not necessarily because I think it's bad content. It's just that sort of content is, like, it takes a lot of effort and a lot of editing to do. I don't understand why we're getting so many bomb upgrades. I really don't. I sort of just don't even want to take these. I'm going to take butt bombs just because it does AoE, but I have no idea what's going on with these. I'm trying to think if there's a bomb upgrade that we have not seen besides sad bombs. We got Curse the Blind, hooray. I don't think that there's been a... I think sad bombs remains as the only other bomb upgrade that we have not seen yet in this run. Here. I thought the Canadian video would do pretty well, but I wasn't expecting a lot just because it's an old series. I have a lot of new subs that have never even seen the How British Are You series, and those were like from, like, what, 3-4 years ago, something like that? But it's always a neat feeling to see a resurgence of popularity of a series that I enjoy doing a lot. I've talked about it at length about doing more edited, like, highly... More labor-induced... What's the best way I can describe this? Not induced labor. Yeah, I'm gonna have a kid on camera. More labor intensive series. By labor, I mean, like, the editing. Can't do that. A giant meathead right there. The How Canadian Are You video, that one took about 4 hours of editing or so, which isn't bad, especially considering, comparatively speaking to my old school, you know, World of Warcraft PvP videos. But that's still kind of up there. And a lot has changed since the Lauder days. You know, back in those days, I actually had time to edit those because I was working a real job and I didn't really have any other thing to work to spend my time on other than going to the gym. And now it's like, okay, well, I could spend a lot of time editing, or I could in that time I could actually go and record more videos. You know? And like I never really understood how people could get another fly item. You know, I think I know the answer to the why are we getting so many bomb upgrades? It's because of chaos. It's just because there's more bomb upgrade items that exist in the game than like almost any other type of upgrade. Small rock would be great. We did get a crawl space. A black market would be awesome as well. Did we get the super secret room? We have not. Right here. And inside of the crawl space here is going to be nothing. Alright. Sort of forgot what I was talking about now. It wasn't important. Anyway. This run, I mean, it's probably going to be a one run. All we have to do is really just clear through the cathedral and we're good on that. I can just let Blue Baby's only friend just do the work. Fight. Epilepsy warning for anyone out there. And with the wafer, I mean, I honestly don't care about... I'm not trying to take damage here, but I just don't care about the damage that we do take. Alright, head on up here. And we're just gonna fly through the cathedral here. This very, very weird run. Try that again here. So, if anything, let this run be a testament to why you don't ever want to take chaos. For those of you who have adopted my conservative playstyle in Isaac, let this be the lesson for you all that the reason why Sinvicta does not like chaos is exactly this reason right here. Because you get these muddied, watered-down runs that don't really give you a whole lot to work with, other than apparently a bunch of bomb upgrades. Which I could be doing a little bit more... I could put a little bit more emphasis on using bomb upgrades, but... It's not that big of a deal, in my opinion. I think that we're gonna... Like, this was a one run as long as we stabilize an HP, which of course we've done. I mean, the wafer is what sealed the deal, really. It's just going to take forever for us to get to the point of, you know, finishing this run. But let it be known that most of the problem is deriving from the fact that we have chaos. And Guppy's tail just made things even worse in that regard. So I don't feel like fighting death, so I'm going to go over here. Try that again, butt bombs, there we go. Got a chariot card, don't really care about that. Just trying to find Isaac. Didn't see a single greed fight in this run, did we? I don't know. Speaking rhetorically now, of course. I mean, I would love to be included in the Tournament of Shame stuff. People have asked me a lot, why am I not? How come I didn't do Tournament of Shame culling, or how come I didn't do Tournament of Shame this or that? It's because I'm not part of the Tournament of Shame crew. The NLSS crew is slightly different than the Tournament of Shame crew. Don't ask me how that happened, but that's just how it is. They have a, you know, it's usually the six of them. It's usually Mouth, Josh, Ryan, Nick, Dan, and Mathis. That's usually it. Then Bear sometimes, Austin sometimes. I've never done a Tournament of Shame video at all. I would love to. Trust me, I would. If they asked me to do it, I would. It's the same reason why, like, you know, people ask me how come I have never been on the co-optional podcast. First of all, I'm not big enough to be on the co-optional podcast. There's no real upside for TB, the company, to do so, other than them just doing it out of the goodness of their own heart. Which TB has helped me a ton in the past. It still helps me to this day on YouTube. I would never ask to be included in the for the co-optional podcast. I've let them know. I say, hey, you know, by the way, if you guys for whatever reason have reached the bottom of the barrel for guests, you know, I'd happily fill in. And that was years ago. But you know, a lot of people seem to think that there's a hidden meaning or reason why I haven't been on the co-optional lounge. I've been on the co-optional lounge plenty. I'm talking about the podcast. And the answer is because they just have never asked me. You know, I get it's the same sort of question people ask me. How come I haven't been on the NLSS, or how come you weren't on the NLSS for this game or that game? It's because they just don't ask me. You know, I'm the type of person who doesn't invite himself to his Curse of the Blind. Hooray! Well, how much you want to bet we're gonna get a bomb upgrade here? Let's see. Halo flies. Steven. Hey, it's damage up. Dead cat. And blank card. Yeah. I did that to activate Swarm Protector, by the way. This is because I don't add. Like, I'm not a person who invites themselves to things. I feel like it's more polite to just wait and be asked. You know, I don't want to say. Hey, I rarely say in our chat group for the NLSS, like, hey, can I be on the show this week? You know, like I don't that's very presumptuous to assume that they're gonna want that or grant that to happen. And same thing goes for the co-optional lounge. I mean, I'm sure I'll be on one day, but I'm certainly not going to force the matter. We're not going to go fight Delirium, so I'm going to wrap it up there. Thank you, everyone. 48 wins in a row. We're heading towards 50, and the streak continues on this whatever run that was, man. It was pure chaos. So I do appreciate it. If you enjoyed this video, let me know by clicking the like button. If you want to see more Isaac content as well, let me know in the comments down below. And as always, I'll see you all in the next episode. Until then, so long, everybody.